Okay, welcome to Westford Academy. We're here to have the Reading Rockets take on the Westford. What are they called here? The Westford?
Junior Ghosts.
The Junior Ghosts. We're here from the broadcast team. So we have our captains on the field. We have Zach Galvin, number 65, Max Rizzo, 64, Max Leone, number 20, and Matt DeCourcy, number 54. So we got the toss. It looks like Reading has won the toss, as Westford has decided which side they're going to defend.
Yeah. A lot of pink out on that field today for Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Great to have Tom Dolan and Todd Ramo back in the booth here. Todd working the camera and Tom over here. We had Max Rizzo, who's one of the captains. His dad was filling in last week, and we got some creative announcing with him, creative yard line markers.
Sorry,
going 45, 50, 55, 60. It was fun. We had a good time.
Yeah. Sorry, I missed it at Frank's expense.
All right, we're at kickoff here in Westford. Westford kicking off to Reading. And deep. Who do we have back there, Tom? You have an angle on those guys?
I'm guessing Colby Goodchild's one of them. And can't see the number on the other one right now. Yeah.
Joe Pawelli. We have kickoff. It's a squibber. They got to get on that ball quickly. It's out of bounds.
Out of bounds.
And it's a penalty.
Is it?
You kick out of bounds. So they'll get probably a 10-yard pickup. First and 10 from the 40-yard line for Reading. First play from scrimmage today. Marsharelli into center. Goodchild in the backfield. It's a handoff up the middle to Beckenhuis. Looks like no gain. We heard a lot of good things about this Reading team, I mean this Westford team, considered probably the best in this league. Although small in number, they're 4-0, and biggest test that Reading's had thus far, from what I'm hearing from the coach.
Just notice that they are small in number. Doesn't even look like they have two full sides.
Second and 9 for Reading. Marshall pitches right. Ben Wright. Maybe a loss of a yard. It's going to be third and long, third and 10 for Reading. Third and 10 from the 40. In motion, Ben Wright.
Ball down on the ground.
Ball on the ground. It's going to be fourth and 12. Back to kick, and Joe Pawelli's got the long snapping duties here. Good snap, and the kick. It's got a good Reading roll, and it rolls to about the 43-yard line, and we'll see this Westford offense for the first time. And here we are at... Oh, I get it. Okay. First and 10 for Westford from their own 43-yard line. We hear a high-powered offense here. Let's see what they have. It's a handoff up the middle. Number 8. Tripped up by Alex DiNapoli. Tripped him up for Westford. Second and 9 for Westford. Shotgun. Twin backs. He's rolling left. He sees an open man. And on the coverage is Rocco Marsharelli. No gain.
No gain.
We get a defensive battle so far here, Tom. And an interesting name, Westford Academy. Is that
a private school name?
I don't think so. I think this is just their high school name. But I think Reading should take a page out of their book. We could call it Reading Academy. I think our kids will get accepted to their target colleges a little bit more.
Do you have to be accepted to the Westford Academy?
No, it is their public high school.
Oh.
And we have third and long. There hasn't been much offense so far, either way. A lot of communication in the defensive backfield.
Weather, certainly.
Shotgun. Oh, we have a flag on this play. Hopefully.
Offside, maybe on Reading.
On Reading. Nope, it's on Westford.
It is on Westford.
This will be coming back. It will be third and 15. Fourth and 9 for Westford. Again, shotgun.
They're going for it.
Oh, quick he punted it.
He quick kicked it.
Tom, it's not a quick kick on fourth down.
No, no. True. Sorry. Is that illegal?
And Reading will take over at the 27-yard line. So our second offensive chance. First and 10 for Reading. Their own 27-yard line. Beck and Hughes in motion. It's a handoff up the middle. Here Colby Goodchild. He's got the edge.
He's turning the corner.
He's there got the first down and more. Could he go all the way? 40, 30, 20,
55, 60.
And it's a touchdown, Reading. Colby Goodchild takes it on the sweep and drives it all the way up the field for a touchdown. We got 6-0. One. We got Murphy in a quarterback with Goodchild and Beckenhuis in the backfield. It's a pitch to Goodchild on the right side. He sees the end zone and gets right in, no problem.
Trots
untouched.
Right untouched.
It's 7-0. Good start for Reading. 7-0 Reading after a great drive. Big run by Reading and Colby Goodchild. Kickoff, we have Giacomo Iapica on the kickoff. It's an onside kick.
Oh, onside kick. Goes down, falls on it.
And they'll take over at their own 50. Westford. First and 10 for Westford.
Westford finding themselves down for the first time this season.
Shotgun. Handoff. No gain. Reading read that. Second and 10. Second and 10 for Westford from the 50-yard line. He's looking to pass. He's got an open receiver. And completion. No.
No good.
Guess it hit the ground. Ref had a good angle at that. Third and 10 for Westford from the 50-yard line. Shotgun. He's rolling right. He's got a lot of pressure up the middle. Reading is swarming him. Maybe 5 or 6 tackles in on that play. And now it's going to be fourth and long. Maybe another punt. It is. Good punt. Over Colby's head. And it's going to go all the way. Hopefully, let's see if it rolls in the end zone. And Reading got a little lucky bounce there. And it's going to come out to the 20-yard line. Or 25. I'm not sure what it is in Pop Warner now.
That's right.
I think that's the first touchback we've seen this year. And it comes out to the 25, we learned, Tom.
Yes.
We get Murphy under center. Iapica out left. Beckenhuis out left as well. Beckenhuis in motion. Fake handoff. Westwood. They read that play. Loss of 2. Second and 10 for Reading. Murphy in the shotgun. He's looking. He's got an open man. It's Goodchild. No gain. Third and 13 for Reading. Goodchild to the right of Murphy. Oh,
uh-oh.
Shotgun over his head. And he covers it. I think Reading's going to have to punt here, fourth and 20. Tom Frato back to punt. Puelli on the snap. Good snap. And the kick. Kind of got it off his foot there. It's going to be maybe at the 15-yard line. So Westford has a big opportunity here from Reading's 15 to try to get those points back. Okay, Westford first and 10 from Reading's 13-yard line. Big opportunity for Westford to get those points back. He's rolling right, quarterback. And doesn't look like there's much there. They're swarming him. Who got to buy the shirt there? That was Colin Donahue.
I was just going to say Colin Donahue.
I beat you to it, Tom.
Yeah. That kid doesn't miss many tackles.
I'm going to keep it running here and just recap some of the game last week. I think you two guys, you made it. You didn't run at the game last week, Tom.
Unfortunate at the
Big plays.
Patriots lost last
week. Oh, yes. Yep, that was. Yeah, we do have the same record as the Patriots, this Reading team, 3-1. And big games. Colby Goodchild scored on a pitch. We had Sean Daugherty, our Gronk, have a touchdown. Okay, we have second and 13 after that short loss. Seem to always go in the shotgun position. Oh, big block on the left side, but people backing him up there. Rocco makes it, tries to make the tackle, and who ends up making that tackle? That was Murphy. It's going to be third and 15. So he had a couple interceptions by James Murphy last week, and also a big interception to end the game by Ryan Strout. And we also had a very exciting thing you missed, Tom. We had some bird doo-doo go on Rocco's helmet, and Coach had to wash that off. That was an exciting moment of last week's game, too. It is third and 15 for Westford. Same formation every time. It's a deep pass. Looks like we have coverage. And Murphy breaks it up. Fourth and 15 for Westford. This is a big fourth down for Reading's defense if they can stop him. He's got a bobble. There's pressure already. And we got DiNapoli and several others in on the tackle there. Great play. Alec Grande in on the tackle. DiNapoli. I didn't see who the last guy was, but three of them swarmed him.
And we have our first player profile of the week, Matt DeCourcy. It's a self-proclaimed nickname at home. He goes by Matt. Very creative. Favorite musical artist is Drake. And favorite sports logo, the Cleveland Cavaliers. Favorite candy, Twix. See that one often.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
Matt DeCourcy coming in the game as we're chatting. His favorite historical figure before he was born is Bo Jackson. First thing he does when he gets home from school is homework. His favorite football drill, the Oklahomas, another common one that they like. The favorite movie is The Blind Side.
Great movie. That.
Great movie.
That's a great movie.
Love that movie.
Some teary moments in that movie, Tom.
There was.
Inspirational.
Yep. Favorite non-football sport, baseball. His favorite place to eat. His parents take him to eat in Reading is Capri Pizza.
And this first quarter is brought to you by Capri. That's our sponsor. Matt's the center.
Are we on or off?
Okay, we have Matt DeCourcy at center. We have Ben Hennessy right guard. Beckenhuis in motion. It's a pitch to Ben Wright. He tries to turn lips, doesn't get anything. Also on the line, we have Jason Anderson in there, and Sean Murphy is also checked into the game. Tom Fratto's in the game as well. Thomas Fratto. Max Leone out wide. No, it's Carter Learned outright. It's a handoff up the middle. Maybe a gain of a yard or two. And it's going to be third and long. Third and 10 for Reading from their own 29-yard line. It's roll out right. There's nothing there. Rocco breaks a tackle and gets a few yards. Probably pick up a four. It's going to be fourth and long. Fourth and long, and it looks like Reading's going to go for it. We got a quick substitution here. Colby Goodchild checks in. Ben Wright checks out.
Deep in their own zone, but Reading's defense has been playing so well.
Yeah. We have Topier split out right. Beckenhuis in motion. It's a handoff up the middle to Colby Goodchild. And they kind of keyed on him on the defense. You could see them looking at number 24 on that one, and they're going to turn it over on down. So Westford takes over on Reading's 35. First and 10 for Westford after taking over on downs. Oh, it's on the ground. He hiked it right through the quarterback's legs. Second and 15 for Westford. At Reading's 41. They're under center here. Handoff up the middle. Reading, he moves the pile a little bit and maybe picks up 5 yards on that. Good effort. 6-7 yards. Wow. Nice power running. We hear Coach Marciarelli yelling, dig deep. You can hear him right across the field here. More power running for Westford.
Oh,
and
ball
the ball's on
the ground again.
Puellian on the tackle, along with Marsharelli. Okay, fourth and long. They're not punting, we believe. Direct snap to center, quarter. No, he's going to run it. He's got some running room. Can Redding swarm and get him in time? They turned him up to the center. They're going to take it over and downs. He picked up about three or four, not enough, and Redding is pumped up. They're taking over on downs. This defense has been playing great today.
Fantastic defense.
First and 10 for Redding. We have Murphy under center. Good child in the backfield. Split out right. Is that Puelli? In motion, Beckenhuis. And good child breaks a couple tackles, picks up 5 yards. It's going to be second and 5 for Redding. Okay, that's Jack Ramo. Second and 5 for Redding. Ramo checks in at tight end. Had a huge catch at practice yesterday. Oh, my God. They were ooing. And Goodchild turns it upfield. He's going to get a first down and more. Pickup of 10. First and 10 for Redding on their own 45-yard line. Catch on Ramo. I got to tell you about that in practice. Murphy under center. DiNapoli split out right. It's a handoff. It's the Edelman play. And nothing there. So on D, they were working the defense, and Jack Ramo caught this long pass for a touchdown, and it was a really impressive pass. And the defense was teasing them a little bit, and I'll tell you, the coaches did not like that. They wanted more seriousness. Coach Buelli got excited during that moment and tried to wake up his defense in practice. Hand off to Goodchild. He's got running room. He breaks a tackle. He's got more. 40-yard line. 35.
He is not getting taken 20, down. He's going.
15,
wow.
10, 5. Touchdown. Good child. He is running through this defense today.
No flags on the field.
Amazing.
He had a tough time keeping up with that.
Westford's in a precarious position right now.
So fast he deep the camera. Come on.
I've ended up with a couple of those before.
13-0 for Redding. And they'll be going for one almost certainly. We've never seen them kick an extra point.
Although they have been working on it quite a bit in practice.
That's true.
In the practice.
For the extra point, to make it 14-0, if they can convert this, Murphy in shotgun. He's got Ben Wright to his left. DiNapoli out right. Oh, snapped over his head. He's going to kneel it down. So we had 13-0. And we'll have a kickoff. And it's the second quarter. 4 minutes left in the second quarter. 13 to zip. 4 minutes left in the second quarter. Redding kicking off. We got Giacomo Iapica kicking off. And here's the kickoff. It's an onside kick once again. And it goes and is recovered at the 43-yard line, 44-yard line for Westford, where they'll take over. First and 10 for Westford. Their own 44-yard line. See Puelli is safety. It's a handoff to the left side, and Thomas Fratto breaks up the play a little bit, but then he shakes a tackle. Big block of Kobe Goodchild, and we have Giacomo on chase. Oh, breaks a tackle. He's out of bounds.
Kobe got.
Who brought him down? I think that was Giacomo Iapica.
I think it was Giacomo knocked him out.
And now Giacomo had a game-saving or a touchdown-saving tackle last week as well, where the play had ran away and he saved a touchdown. It was a last resort tackle. He's done it again 2 weeks in a row. Big plays.
Great play by Westford. They had him in the backfield and he broke free. It's kind of like that play Colby had.
Yeah, we've heard that they're great runners on this team. And it's going to be first and 10 from Redding's 24-yard line. It's a handoff up the middle. He's got some running room. 5 yard pickup. Second and 5. Second and 6 from the Redding 20. Kobe Goodchild walked off the field. A little shaken up on that last play. He's walking off under his own power there, so hopefully he's okay. And who do we have on the defensive line? We got a better angle here, Tom. We can shout out some of these players' names that are out there. I see
James Murphy out to the right.
Jesse Daugherty on the left side. Iapico out left. DiNapoli on the right side. Beckenhuis deep. Puelli. Shotgun snap. He trips a little bit. He finds an open man. Finds his tight end. He's picked up some yards. And, keeps on going down to the 5-yard line. Almost the 5-yard line. It's going to be first down and goal for Westford. Starting to see some of that offense we heard about by Westford. They're starting to move the ball, and you're starting to see them break some tackles, too. It's first and goal from the 7.
Oh, ball on the ground.
Found the ball on the ground. But he shakes loose, uses it, and he's going to score. Touchdown, number 12.
Flag on the play, though.
Oh, we have a flag on the play.
Guessing
this
maybe
could come back.
False start. It's actually
false start. Moving it back 5 yards. Mm-hmm. Redding caught a break there. So we have first and goal for Westford. And it's another beautiful day for a Reading Pop Warner game here. We have another day where it's just pouring, Tom. And just to let you know, we're up in a booth. They have a great booth here at Westford. And Todd is doing his best. There's certain angles he's not going to be able to grab. Like at this angle, we're not going to be able to see the left corner of the end zone. So he's doing his best. And the other end zone, we'll have trouble seeing the right corner. But we'll do the best to get you the We want them to run this play to the right so we can get some good focus on this play, Todd.
Tell the coaches.
Yep. Shotgun for Westford. Number 12's rolling back. He's rolling right. Jesse Daugherty on the... Oh, nice play.
Wow, big hit.
Is that Beckenhuis broke up that play? Good time hit. Second and goal for Westford. Their typical formation here, shotgun with 2 running backs. He's rolling out left. There's pressure all around him. About 5 players tackled him for Reading. Alec Grande, Alex DiNapoli, Colin Donahue, Jesse Daugherty. They're all over him. Okay, we have the defense back. We see Josh Robichaud is playing nose guard. Colin Donahue as well. Dylan Sweetser in on the line, defensive line. Defense has been playing great so far. I'm sure Coach Puelli is very pumped up,
lines,
as Todd Ramo just mentioned.
The lines especially playing tough, breaking through quite often.
Third and goal from the 20 for Westford. He's looking for the pass. He's got an open man, and it's a touchdown. Touchdown, Westford. It's 13-6. Okay, with 2 minutes left, Westford is going to go for their extra point. They're going for 1, it appears, after a big touchdown connection there. Touchdown pass connection. He's rolling left. He seems to have some running room, and he's going to convert it. So we have 13-7 with 2 minutes left in the second quarter, and Reading will receive the kickoff momentarily.
Ben Wright.
Ryan Strout and Ben Wright back deep. And awaiting kickoff.
Watching the onside.
It is kind of a squib kick. And Alex DiNapoli pounces on it quickly. Nice recovery. They'll take over at the 41. And we've got an adjustment on the clock right now. It's actually 59 seconds left. So the game clock and official clock seem like they were just matched up. That's all right. All right, we have first and 10 for Reading on their own 42-yard line. We have Iapica coming back in at quarterback, I believe. Yep. No, Rocco Masciarelli, yes. Quarterback. Sixes and eights look very similar. It's a pitch to Ben Wright. And he does not have running room. He's tackled for a loss, maybe a 6-yard loss. It'll be second and 17. All right, we just had a visit from Justin Ramo, as we usually do. He usually visits us here in the visits us here in the booth. Usually needs money or extra clothing.
Today needs a coat.
Yeah, it was a coat.
A little rainy.
Yeah, a little rainy out there. So good to have Justin in the booth. All right, second and 16 for Reading, with 40 seconds left in the half. It's a pitch to the right side. Oh, it's a fake. And almost a completion to Jesse Daugherty. Our Gronk.
I got tricked again.
Oh, sorry, Tom. I took this.
It's okay.
Third and 16 for Reading. Shotgun to Murphy. He hands it up the middle to Kobe Goodchild. There's nothing there. It's going to be fourth and long. We'll probably see a punt here.
Might see him.
As we're winding down the first half here, we're going to do a player profile. It's Max Rizzer. He's a Parker middle schooler, number 64. He's right standing at the 40-yard line there, and sixth grader. His favorite musical artist is AC/DC. My son wrote that down, too, and I don't even think he knows what that is. Yeah. So confused by that one. Doesn't have a favorite candy. That's a shocker. Nobody's left that one blank. His favorite historical sports figure is Larry Bird. That matches mine. He likes to do his homework when he gets home from school. His favorite football drill is the bear crawls, but he has it parenthesized here, parenthetically, without pads. So he likes it. Likes to be light on that. Favorite movie, Austin Powers. What's the rating on that, Tom? Austin Powers. I gotta talk to the Rizzo family.
It's different standards.
He likes to ski when he's not playing football and enjoy spending time with his grandparents. What a nice kid. And they're looking long. A surprising last play. They went for it, and that could have been run back for a touchdown if he grabbed that. So Reading was very fortunate he didn't come up with it. So I think we might be looking at the last play of the half here coming up by Westford. All right, first and 10 for Reading, taking over on downs, 18 seconds left. They might have one or two plays left if they have a timeout. Shotgun snap. He's looking deep. He does not have an open man, and Murphy intercepts
Murphy
it.
Murphy comes up with another interception.
Oh, pitch.
Uh-oh.
And Rocco will rightly kneel down on it, and that will be, I think, the last play of the half.
It might not be. It might be give us one more play.
Yep. Did Murphy come up hurt a little bit on that pitch? He looked like he twisted his ankle. So we have 13-7, Tom. I think really good half. I think Reading's got to be pleased. You know, other than a couple plays that Westford was able to break out on, I think they played overall very well. The offense was able to move the ball, and the defense certainly.
The defense played fantastic, strong, with the exception of a couple of great plays, which just fluke.
Yeah. Well, and this Westford team's a powerhouse, too. So I bet the coaching staff's pretty pleased with this first half. We'll be back in the third quarter. Oh, yeah, they'll make some adjustments. That's Todd Ramos. He doesn't have a headset, so he's passing things to us.
Is there an S on the end of Ramos?
Did I put an S there? Did I say Ramos? Just an O, Ramo. Sorry for the mispronunciation.
Turn from Italian to Spanish.
Sometimes I stumble on the words here. All right, we'll see you in the second half. Okay, we have the kickoff. Iapica is lining up the kickoff. Let's see if he tries another onside kick. I think he's done that a couple times already. They did it last week as well. It hasn't worked yet. And here's the kickoff. Nope, it's a full kickoff this time. And it's going to be kneeled down at the 31-yard line for Westford. And they'll take over from there. First and 10 for Westford from their own 30-yard line. Shotgun formation. Two running backs. It's a handoff to the left side. Avoids a couple tacklers. And it looks like Colby Goodchild is going to push him out of bounds after about an 8-yard pickup. Second and 2. Second and 2 for Westford. We're starting to see that elusiveness and power running that we heard about with this Westford team these last few series. Shotgun handoff right up the middle. A little bit better coverage here, but he does pick up the first down. I think he did. He got the first down. First and 10 from the 42-yard line. First and 10 from the 42-yard line. Westford, shotgun formation. He's rolling right. Good defensive coverage. They play contained very well on that. And Alex DiNapoli is trying to make a tackle there, and we have Murphy pushing him out of bounds. Kind of a broken play that they ended up getting some yards out of.
Number 53, Tim Burns, in there on that tackle.
Nice. Seems like a lot of the biggest plays against our defense have been broken plays going one way, and the teams have run it back to the weak side. Shotgun. One back. DiNapoli on contain. Jesse Daugherty. He breaks a few tackles. This quarterback has some good running skills. Almost another first down. I think he has it. First and 10 from the 35-yard line. Westford has a put together a few plays here. Handoff right up the middle. Oh, breaks a tackle. Breaks a couple tackles. He's going to score. Right up the middle of the Reading defense. We have a tie ball game. 13-13. They're going for one on the extra point. Shotgun. The ball's on the ground. He turns back up, and he powers through a couple tacklers and gets the extra point. So Westford takes the lead. It's a one-point lead with 7 minutes and 40 seconds left in the third quarter. Seems like Reading was gang-tackling a lot in the first quarter, but lately it seems like we have just one tackler trying to bring down these tough Westford runners, and it's not working the last few series.
Westford team blocking.
Running back for kickoff, we have Ryan Strout and Colby Goodchild. Looks like they're setting up for an onside kick. A lot of adjustment on the Westford kickoff team here. They just changed sides. And here's the kickoff. No, he's kicking deep, and he's got Colby Goodchild on the reception. He's turning it up left. He's got a little running room. Breaks a tackle and brings it all almost out to midfield. Nice run back by Colby. So Reading will take over first and 10 on their own 47-yard line. First and 10 for Reading. We have Murphy under center, it looks like. And who's the lone setback? Is that Ben Wright? We'll get DiNapoli out right. Oh,
false start.
It's going to be first and 15 for Reading after false start. First and 15 for Reading. It's a reverse. And, oh, the ball's on the ground. And I think Westford has recovered it. Well, that's unfortunate for Reading. They're going to give up the ball in their own territory here. And Westford definitely has the momentum now, Tom.
They do.
Okay, after that fumble recovery, it's first and 10 for Westford on Reading's 32-yard line. Shotgun snap. Quarterback's looking to run. He mostly looks to run when he goes back to pass. Oh, he just a pitch. What a great play. He pitched it, and he's got a running back's going to get another 10 yards on that play. Very alert play by the quarterback and that running back.
Dangerous play.
Yeah. It's going to be first and 10 on Reading's 22-yard line, 23-yard line. You know, the defense had him.
Defense had him. That was like a bad call on the referee's part. That should have been a dead play.
Should have been a dead ball, yeah. They had him in their grasp. Happened to them last week, too. Similar play against Reading.
Risky play to throw the ball, pitch it.
Yep.
Wet weather.
First and 10 from the 22-yard line. He's under center. It's a handoff up the middle. And they are scoring again. Right up the middle. Similar to a lost touchdown play. We are just not getting in front of these runners in swarm tackle. First and 10. Oh, no. This is for the extra point.
This is for the extra.
Yep. They're going for one. It's 20-13. And it's a shotgun snap. And he hands it off to number 11. And he's taking it up the middle. Is that enough? Nope. So it's going to be 20-13 with 6 minutes left to go in the third quarter.
The next player profile that we have today is Max Leone. His favorite musical artist is Drake. One interesting fact about Max is he has a twin sister.
Kate.
Yeah. That's right. Not his favorite.
She's
candies.
Quite a sportswoman herself, too,
she
Tom.
She is. Favorite candy is the Sour Patch Kids. His favorite historical figure, Jerry Rice. Fantastic wide receiver. First thing he does when he gets home is his homework. Oklahoma is his favorite drill, and The Blind Side, his favorite movie. And his favorite sport outside of football is lacrosse, which we've been told he's a fantastic lacrosse player.
Yeah, he is. I've heard from his coach. He's a great player. We have the kickoff. And it looks like it's going to Ryan Strout. He's got the ball, and he's running it back, and he's got some daylight. And he takes it over the 50-yard line to about the 49. Great run back by Ryan.
Great holding on to the ball.
First and 10 for Reading. Murphy under center. Ramo is tight end. Puelli outright. And it's a pitch to Kobe Goodchild. He's going to get the first down and more. He's running hard. Down to the 37-yard line. Big pickup.
Plugged away.
37-yard line. Puelli outright. First and 10 from the 37-yard line. Puelli outright. Carter learned it out left. Murphy into center. It's a pitch to Goodchild. He turns it back. Nothing there. Oh, he breaks a tackle. Breaks another tackle. They take him down for a loss. Second and 16. Second and 15 from Westford's 41-yard line. Looks like Kobe Goodchild got re-injured there again. Ref sent him out. Murphy looks, rolls right. He's got an open receiver. It's Jesse Daugherty for about a 10-yard pickup, 5-yard pickup. And that'll be second and about 7 for Reading. For Reading. Third and 7 for Reading. Ayapika outright. It's a handoff up the middle. Ball's on the ground. Westford recovers. They'll take over. It's first and 10 from their own 37. First and 10 for Westford. They're on their own 37-yard line after that fumble recovery. And there's a timeout on the field. Okay, first and 10 for Westford. It's a handoff up the middle. He's got some yards. Great quickness and change of direction. And breaking tackles. Wow, he's a great runner. He's going to go all the way.
Oh, illegal block
10,
on that.
5, touchdown. I don't see any flags on the field. It's 26-13, Westford.
It looked like he
great
got
run.
Blocked
he is a
from
player.
Behind on our last player there.
Going for one. This would make it 27-13 if they convert. Shotgun. Quarterback's rolling left with all intentions of running, of course. And he is going to get right in there. He beat them to the corner. 27-13 with 3 minutes and 44 seconds left in the third quarter. Go live. Okay, we're sitting with the Burden family in the broadcast booth here at Westford Academy. And his grandparents and his dad is here. He's kicking off. It's Peter Burden. And it looks like it's going to go out of bounds. And his grandparents are upset about that kickoff, I can see right now. But the Reading team needs every advantage they can get to get back in this game. So they'll take over at, I think, is that a 10-yard penalty? Or is it, how do they do that?
It went out at about the 45.
I don't know if they give, if it's a, I think it's a penalty when you kick it out of bounds.
It is. Yeah, so they give it 5 yards.
No, I guess not. Is that where it went out?
No, I think it went out a little further back.
Okay. First and 10. Are we on? First and 10. Murphy and shotgun. Looks like Marsharelli's to his left. He is. He's looking left. It looks like he's going to be brought down for sack. Second and long for Reading. Second and 18 or something. Second and 15 for Reading. Murphy under center. DiNapoli outright. He's looking. It's a handoff up the middle. Flag on the play. Maybe a gain of 2. Let's see what this penalty's all about. It looks like it was a legal motion. Offsides. They're going to move it back 5. It's going to be second and 20. Second and 20. Kobe Goodchild checks in the game. Alex DiNapoli's outright. It's a pitch to Goodchild. He turns left. Picks up a couple. Third and 20 for Reading. Okay, third and 20 from their own 40-yard line. Murphy under center. Good child. Long back. Beck and Hughes. Oh, he's throwing it. And it's intercepted. It looks similar to a play they ran earlier, Tom, where they pitched a good child, then he looks deep. And it seemed like Westford was really ready for it this time.
Yes, they were.
So they're going to take over on Redding's 47-yard line. And I'll tell you, since the end of the first half through this whole second half, it's been all Westford. Oh, okay, yeah. First and 10 for Westford. After that interception, it's going to be on Redding's 47-yard line. So let's see if the Redding defense can slow them down a little bit here. They have not had any luck doing that in the last several series. Handoff up the middle. And good tackle by Colin Donahue. And Rocco Marciarelli. And Joe Puelli. Okay, our last player profile of the game is the other captain of the game, Zach Galvin. He's number 65. He's a sixth grader at Parker Middle School. He goes by the nickname Pokemon. His favorite musical artist, Shakira. Enjoys a Twix bar. Favorite historical figure, Tom Dolan told me what this was, Harambee. And it's second and five for Westford. They take over. That was the end of the third quarter. Ball on the ground. I think Redding has recovered it. And it is. It's Redding's ball.
Redding ball.
As we continue with the player profile. His favorite movie is The Secret Life of Pets and likes playing rugby when he's not playing football. And his favorite place to go in Redding is Washington Street Park. So that is our last player profile. Oh, we found him on the sidelines there, number 65. Todd has been searching through that whole player profile to track down Zach and finally got him. So now it's first down for Redding.
Right at the 40-yard line.
First down for Redding. Let's see if we can get some of these points back. Down by two touchdowns. It's a pitch to Goodchild. He's looking right. He's got some running room. He's picked up. Oh, yeah, he's
turning
10
the corner.
And more. First down for Redding. About a 15-yard pickup. A lot of excitement on the Redding sideline now. They're trying to get back in this game. Murphy under center. It's a handoff up the middle to Beckenhuis. And he's all bottled up. It's going to be second and long. Second and long for Redding. Hand off to Ben Wright. He turns it outside. Gets a little bit of running room and then is brought down. Third and 10 for Redding. Third and 9 from Westford's 45-yard line.
Come on, Rockets. Let's go. First.
It's a handoff up the middle to Kobe Goodchild, and he picks up about 6. It's going to be a fourth down. I think we're in four-down territory here. I think we're going to be going for it.
Absolutely.
They're not going to be punting the ball off to them. In fact, it looks like they're still in a hurry-up offense here. We got Puelli in on offense. We have Ryan Stroud in as a wide receiver. Puelli outright. Rocco Marciarelli in the slot. Goodchild, a lone setback. It's a handoff. Oh, it's a fake handoff. Murphy's going to be sacked. The ball's on the ground. And it is Westford's ball. Okay, first and 10 for Westford on their own 45. James Murphy got banged up a little bit on that last play. Walked off. And his quarterback keeper to the left side. He turns it up. Maybe gets a couple. Second and 8. Second and 9. Westford not taking plenty of time between plays now with the two touchdown lead and clock running. It's a shotgun. Handoff up the middle. Thomas Fratto trying to make a tackle there. Strung out a little bit more by Aiden Beckenhuis. And nice tackle by Aiden.
Hand off to number 16, Josh Keith.
You know when you're tackled by Aiden Beckenhuis, boy, he's an aggressive player.
Yeah. Gave Quinn a concussion last year.
Shotgun. Third and five. He's looking. He's got an open receiver. Puelli in on the tackle. Is that Puelli? Who is that? Nope. It was Rocco Marciarelli.
Under friendly fire, Quinn and him were tackling the same player. And came in.
Fourth down. Doesn't look like they're setting a punt here. Oh, no, they are. This is their punt formation. And Goodchild's going to go back deep. I wonder if they're going to fake this here.
They might.
From the 50-yard line. Nope, they are going to punt. And it goes to Aiden. Aiden's going to let it roll. Hopefully it gets in the end zone for him. Oh, no. That's not good. That's going to be on the 2-yard line.
Ooh, oh, no.
So Redding with a 2-touchdown deficit and way deep on their own in their own territory.
I've seen Colby run further.
First and 10 from their own 4-yard line is Redding. Got some new players checking in the game here. Is that Rocco Marciarelli as quarterback? It's a handoff up the middle. And they're powering for some yards there. Who is that? It's probably Aiden Beckenhuis. He runs like that. Who else could it be?
Ben Wright? No, there's Ben Wright outside.
It is a 2nd and 7 for Redding. With a big power run there. I think we have Topier out left. And it's a handoff up the middle again. No gain. Quinn Dolan checks in. Split right. Topier left. Beckenhuis in the slot. It's a pitch right. And maybe about 5 yards on the play. Four yards of a pickup. And it's going to be fourth down for Redding. Fourth and long for Redding. Deep in their own end. Oh, it's a fumble. And it looks like it was recovered by Redding, maybe on the goal line. Westford takes over, and it's going to be first and goal for Westford. Goal for Westford on Redding's 1-yard line. 3 minutes left in the game. And they're going to power up the middle. Seem to move the pile a little bit. No signal yet. And we have a touchdown. It's going to be 33-13. With an extra point upcoming. That might be too much for Redding to come back from now this late in the game, Tom.
I believe it is, Dave, unfortunately.
We get an extra point coming up by Peter Burden. His grandparents cheering him on here. Oh, it's a bad snap. And it's going to be a non-converted extra point. 20 stuff. Kickoff. It's an onside kick. And it looks like Alex DiNapoli scooped it up and is going to take it. Can he take it all the way? Let's go, Alex. Down to the 20-yard line. 15. What a big run. Big,
huge run.
Big reception. Big return for Alex DiNapoli. Takes an onside kick all the way back. Let's see if Redding can turn this into some points. After a big return from Alex DiNapoli. First and 10. From Westford's 14-yard line. Beckenhuis in motion. It's a handoff to Beckenhuis. He's got the corner. Maybe a yard. 2nd and long. Second and 10 for Redding. Rocco Marciarelli under center. Goodchild, the lone setback. He's going back to pass. He has an open man.
Ooh.
Who was that? Is that DiNapoli or Strout?
Might have been Strout.
Was it Strout?
Can't see the...
Marciarelli under center. It's a handoff to Goodchild to the right side. Yeah, hey, pick up a three, four. It's going to be fourth down. Fourth and seven for Renning. Shotgun snap to Marciarelli. He's looking deep, and he's got it intercepted. Westford's trying to bring it back now through the interception and bring it back to about the 15-yard line. They'll take over. And that's the game. It's 33-13. Westford wins the game. And after a strong start by Reading, after that first quarter, Tom, they seem to just lose all momentum. The Westford team we heard about seemed to come right, able to pound the ball down the middle and run on the outside.
Really, really tough game.
Yeah. Yeah, that second half they really dominated. We couldn't get any momentum. They got all the turnovers, it seemed, as well. So, tough loss. So the Reading team slips to 4-2, 3-2. And we know they'll go back and work hard in practice this week and try to bounce back next week. So we're going to pass it over to the B team here. And there's Molly Strout right there going by.
One of our
broadcast partners who is working the cameras on the sidelines today.
Should we do the family profile, the Strout family
the
profile?
The Strout family profile. I think that was it. I don't see anybody else from the Strout family.
Right.
So we're signing off. We'll let the B team get in here. They're very eager to take over the headsets.